Non, rien de rien. Non, je ne regrette rien.
Alright, you got me. There's no new game plus, but there is post-game content, so we should probably do that, huh? Gotta start off in Golden Yoshi's Chateau because there's a lovely note for us. Not sure how, because I can't imagine any possible way in which a Yoshi could actually write something, but it's happened and we must deal with it. Basically, the post-game content of this game consists of getting the last four cards, of which this is one. Lord Boo, proprietor of End of World Cutscene Sorting Company Tell It To Me Straight Incorporated, told us to come back and see him after we'd killed everyone. We have killed everyone, so here we are. I love to think that Lord Boo just knew that Roth was a whiny loser this whole time. If you've been following the bonus videos, you'll have seen three of these bonus levels being played. Now that the game has been finished, we can enter the last one. It's rather cleverly titled. Anyway, I end up rushing this bit and always end up either getting hit by the bullet bills or dropping straight down under the munchers. Oh, Flea, will you never learn? No, probably not. Anyway, you may notice that we've got a key, and if you haven't noticed that we've got a key, please notice that I've got a key. But rather oddly, it's not for a secret exit keyhole like it normally is, but instead it's for, well, something else. I'm not going to spoil it. But it's something that you wouldn't have any reason to believe existed unless you'd already played the level, so it's impossible to know that you'll need a key on your first go. So what normally happens is, when you first play, you get to the thing that you need the key for, realize that you need a key for it, then you have to kill yourself, go to the shop, buy a key, and then get all the way back to where the thing where you need the key is, or is... what? It's Liam is the point, okay? It's Liam. It's also beyond this swamp, so that's nice and convenient. Mm-hmm. Doopliss! He's not a main car- well, I guess, if he's been impersonating Golden Yoshi all this time, I guess he technically is a main character, huh? But he only appeared on screen as himself once, and even then all he did was get whined at by Whiny McWhine, so... does that really count? I don't know. But it does raise the rather excellent question of just who's going to be on the final card anyway. I mean, who's left? I don't even know. Frankly's got a card, Frankly's wife has a card, that pirate lady what runs a shop on the beach has a card. I mean, who's left? There's the plant guys, the bubbles, are they important enough? They're not even specific. Maybe the next last card's just gonna be all the bad guys, all the enemies, just on one big card. Probably won't fit though. Maybe the caption will be something really, really short like, "Do not touch these." I did not think that through there. Fuck. Could just be the bosses on their own, perhaps. There's five of them. There'd be a bit more room, maybe you could have a bit of a longer thing. Instead of "don't touch these," "don't touch these," "throw things at these." Could be. We're gonna find out pretty soon, actually, because we're getting near the end of the level. It's B-B-Birdo! If you've never played Doki Doki Mario 2, the Birdo fights are from that, and they work exactly the same way here. Pick up eggs, throw eggs at him. If it hits, it hurts. I kinda fuck up here because, oh. Alright then, whatever. Anyway, on the other side of the Angry Bird, we find a fully furnished cave. I wonder who could possibly live in a house like this. Oh, it's... I don't think this counts as a level title drop. Maybe. Oh no. Oh, please don't. It's not. Oh god, it is. It is Grandpa, and his name is Grandpa. How could you not have imagined that? It's friggin' Mario. Mario solving your problems is as inevitable as the friggin' tide coming in. And farce does not mean what you think it means. Why? Why did you need them to find the letter first? Tell us, please. But you were there, though! They could have just killed you there if they wanted you dead. They wouldn't have left and then came back. And so he runs off into a cave to live alone in order to not die? I don't think that makes sense. But what's he gonna give us? For reuniting him with his grandson, he's going to give us a trading card of himself. He had a lot of free time up there, I would imagine. And this is what you're left with. No fanfare, no credits, no real ending, just Mario standing on the level select screen staring at you and staring at me. I know, Mario. I know. A year and a fucking half. Goodbye, everybody.